Going on YouTube, welcome to the shop. Today I'm going to attempt to repair this power supply. Put too much of a load on it, and it pretty much burned this thing up. I mean, burned it up really well. I don't know if you can see the charring right there. Actually, the wire just came out. It's just unbelievably stiff and stuff. It's just, I don't know if you see the board in that area right here. It's a little brown. It's a one-sided circuit board, so I think it'll be okay. A little discolored right here, but it's not too bad. I mean, the only thing I could do is just try and see what happens. I mean, parts weren't that expensive. I'm pretty much replacing everything on this side. The capacitor, those two diodes, transformers got to go. I think everything else is okay. Kind of checked some of this stuff out a while back, and I've had it for a while, but I just haven't gotten around to fixing it. It's not a big priority because I've got several other ones and like this, and a couple homemade ones like this. But all right, well, let's get some of these components out. Guess I could have turned my soldering iron on, but I didn't do it. God, that thing is just, you can hear it. I don't know if you can hear it or not. It's just not too good. Sometimes putting in a little bit of solder on the tip helps it transfer the heat quicker. I need to get me something to get that stupid thing off there. Hang on, I'll be back. I need a pair of pliers. Alrighty, let's see if we can get this stupid thing off here. Sucker's on there really good, I don't know why it won't come off. There we go. That for the new one. Looks like they put conformal coating on the on the screws here, I guess, to keep them from coming loose. I'll probably put some Loctite on it since I don't have any conformal coating. Didn't come off. Or I missed one, actually. Gotta say, I really like this Vessel screwdriver. You can twist it right there at your fingertips. It's awesome. Brand new transformer. Hopefully some of these holes will line up, and it looks like they will. I think, maybe. Is that gonna work? I do believe it will. Let's see. Yeah, I think that'll work. All right. Just need a little dab of it. Don't need much of it. Huh. Be better if I had four hands. See if we can get that in there. I think I already moved it. Just lost it. Yeah, I just lost it. I don't know where it went. It's okay, get another one. Maybe. Well, not doing too good with this. Get in there. There we go. Okay, that's better. That's better. Now where's my other one? Just be slightly off if I can. Nope, it works perfect. Awesome. Oh. Yeah, I got it stuck in there now. Love having nut drivers. They make it a little easier. Well, tin this, make it just a wee bit easier, I hope. There we go. Definitely want to get that back over there, so just in case there's any mechanical movement, it won't short. Trying to force it back into the hole by loosening up the other connection a little bit. I have to actually take it out and then redo it. Yeah, probably. Yep. That's okay. I need some solder wick. Let's see what we got here. And take that off there. Just trying to open up the hole so I can get the two wires in there together. Just like that. Nope, good connections. And I'll wire tie that together. Do these connections in a moment. Take out that capacitor. I'm just heating the joint up and just kind of rocking the capacitor back and forth just to get it out. Comes right out. And I'm going to take some solder wick here and clean up the hole a little bit. Maybe. Actually, let me cut this excess off. Just trying to clean up the holes a little bit so it's a little easier to get the new one in there. soldered it to it. Come on, get off there. A little bit more. Okay, I think that might be enough. Using a little bit better capacitor, had a YEC. I don't know if you can see that or not. I'm placing it with a Nichicon. I don't know if I got the holes open enough or not. No, I don't think I did. Let's see, now get that diode out of there. Bought some diodes off of Amazon, and unfortunately I didn't really look at where they were coming from. They were coming from Thailand, and they took 2 months to get here. I mean, literally 2 months. I couldn't believe it. Come on, get out of there. Oh well, 10 diodes for $5. That's not too bad, I guess. I just don't know what brand they are. So I don't know if they're any good or not. I hope they are. Yeah, I just bent one. Nah, won't come out. Definitely need a third hand here. I'm having a hard time getting it out. I can't pull on it and got it that time. There we go. It was just getting too hot. I couldn't touch it. Some of that out. Just doing the one side just to hold it in there. I don't want to start at the other side until I get the wire a little closer. Has a lot of solder. There we go. Thank you. One more wire to replace. Looks like it's empty, but it's not. Something not right with that. For some reason it does not want to evacuate, so we're going to see. There we go, that's all it was, a little something in there. Time's up. Oh, that's funny. I think I got the connections all done. Nothing to do but try it. Let's give it a go. You know what? I think I need to check that fuse. Oh, there's no fuse in it. I'll be back. Okay, I put a fuse in it, so hopefully everything will work now. Maybe I can get her going. What am I looking for? Okay, let's see. Ooh. Get my little voltage meter here. Turn it on. No explosions. See what we got. 13.78. Just like we're supposed to. Yeah, got my cords, my wires all tangled up as usual. Let's see what we got here. I hope I'm in the right place. Okay. All looks good. All right. Awesome. Looks like we have a working power supply again. I do believe that's it. All right, well, thanks a lot for watching. Subscribe, like, comment. Let me know what you think. Thanks. Actually, I'll do a little. I thought you could see the meter on there, but you can't. So I don't know if you can see that now or not. Yep, I guess you can. Couldn't see it before, but yeah, it's working. All right, thanks a lot, guys and gals.